we don't easily get a lot of signals coming from space. But recently, we have received one from our backyard, from Orion Nebula. Orion Nebula is situated just below the Orion's belt, and it is a magnificent sight to see using a telescope. A few days ago, while observing this Orion Nebula using the James Webb Space Telescope,
scientists saw
some interesting signals coming from there. They were shocked to see this and were not able to understand why and from exactly where these signals were coming from. What is causing the signals? So, if you take a look at this image over here, you'll notice some interesting things. Most of these are actually new stars that are still growing and evolving. But when scientists took a closer look at the Orion Nebula using different types of light, like infrared, with the James Webb Space Telescope, they found something intriguing. These objects are a bit tricky to understand. Not super weird, just challenging to explain. They seemed like individual planets, but they didn't fit the usual profile of brown dwarfs, which are what we typically expect for solo planetary objects. We'll dive into some new discoveries about brown dwarfs in a bit. But for now, these objects appear to have masses similar to Jupiter or even several times greater. Alright, so these objects we're talking about are way less massive than your typical brown dwarf. James Webb Space Telescope has already spotted around 500 of these just in the past few months. Most of them are what we call free-floating rogue planets, which means they're basically planets wandering around without a star to orbit. It's something we knew existed out there, and we have found a few before, but finding so many at one place is pretty remarkable. Out of those 500, about 8 of them really caught scientists' attention. They turned out to be binaries, which is just a fancy way of saying pair of planetary objects orbiting each other randomly. But here's the kicker. These binary systems are similar to mass of Jupiter, and they can be pretty close together, like 0.5 astronomical units, or as far as 400 astronomical units. Now, these discoveries were already puzzling enough, but here's where it gets even more interesting. Nobody had a clue how these pairs formed. It didn't make sense that so many of them were binaries, especially with such similar masses. The usual way we think planets form, through protoplanetary disks, could not just explain it. So, because of this big mystery and the fact that these objects were so unusual, researchers, whose paper you can find in the description, decided to investigate further using different frequencies of light. Let's delve deeper into figuring out what is these objects really are. At this stage, it's unclear whether they're planets, odd brown dwarfs, small failed stars, or something else entirely new to us. Given that, we're looking at the Orion Nebula, which is relatively close to us in cosmic terms. Studying these objects isn't too tricky. Modern telescopes can usually capture enough detail to give us insights into their surfaces. Naturally, scientists turned to radio telescopes to gather more information. This is crucial because different types of celestial bodies emit distinct radio waves. For instance, stars and even failed stars like brown dwarfs emit specific radio emissions similar to those we observed from the Sun. On the other hand, brown dwarfs might exhibit unique features such as massive auroras, which have been observed in other well-known brown dwarfs also. Interestingly, recent research has even confirmed auroras using infrared light from the James Webb Space Telescope rather than radio waves. A study focused on a brown dwarf called W1935 detected methane emissions from its surface, which is a bit unusual since methane typically absorbs light rather than emitting it. This discovery adds another layer to our understanding of these enigmatic objects. Furthermore, the study reveals an intriguing temperature inversion within the brown dwarf. Especially, the deeper regions of the brown dwarf appeared colder than the upper layers, indicating a rise in temperature with altitude. This phenomenon mirrors what we observe on gas giants like Jupiter and Saturn, particularly in the regions where auroras are typically found. The combination of temperature inversion and methane emissions suggests the presence of powerful and potentially unique auroras in the brown dwarf's atmosphere. These auroras would heat up the upper atmosphere, causing the emission of methane molecules and giving the brown dwarf a similar appearance to what we see in the image. Since auroras generally produce specific radio emissions, researchers were keen to examine these objects in radio light. Gas giants like Jupiter typically emit gigahertz frequencies due to their internal magnetic fields, which are generated by hydrogen turning into metal under extreme pressure. To investigate, researchers utilized previous data from the National Radio Astronomy Observatory, as many observations in this region had already been conducted. Initially, they didn't find anything remarkable. However, they eventually stumbled upon something peculiar in one of the binary pairs. So there is this one object in the mix, nicknamed Jumbo 24, that's emitting incredibly strong radio waves. Interestingly, it's also the heaviest of the bunch. With these objects orbiting each other at the closest possible distance, the emission from Jumbo 24 are consistent and robust, falling within the 6 to 10 GHz range. Now, if these emissions were indeed from auroras, we would expect them to fluctuate over time, with occasional bursts. But that's not what we're seeing here. Instead, these steady emissions suggest something different, possibly synchrotron radiation, which occurs when electrons move rapidly around a massive body. Think of it like what we see in radiation belts, such as the Van Allen belts around Earth. However, there is a twist. Typically, strong radio emissions like this indicate the presence of powerful magnetic fields. But strangely, these emissions aren't polarized, meaning they don't come from regions with strong magnetic fields. This adds to the mystery. To top it off, these emissions are much stronger than anything we have ever seen from brown dwarfs or planets. This has led to the speculation that maybe one of these radio waves aren't coming from objects themselves, but from something else nearby. Yet, the chances of that are extremely slim. So whatever this binary system is, it's a real head-scratcher. It's unlike anything we have ever encountered before. Some have even proposed that it might even be entirely a new type of radio object that we haven't yet wrapped around our heads. These signals are different from what we typically see from planets or brown dwarfs, and they're much stronger without coming from regions with strong magnetic fields. Quite the enigma, what do you say? At some point, there was a speculation that these objects might be pulsars, neutron stars, or something similar, but that theory doesn't hold up because their appearance in infrared light would be different. And no, aliens aren't the answer either. The signals from these objects appear entirely neutral, chaotic, and not at all organized, resembling what we typically see from natural cosmic objects. The fact that both these components of this binary emit similar levels of radio signals, yet with enough variation to rule out artificial sources, adds to the puzzle. At present, there's no explanation for what these objects are, since none of the other binary systems produce similar emissions. It suggests that Jumbo 24 is a unique object worthy of further investigation by other studies. This mystery is likely to endure for some time. However, it underscores remarkable capabilities of the James Webb Space Telescope. It is the first ever telescope ever to directly observe these objects, despite the fact that the Orion Nebula is relatively close to us. In fact, its power was demonstrated recently when it detected different isotopes of ammonia, methane, and water on a cold brown dwarf known as WISE-J1828, located about 33 light-years away. The observations of WISE-J1828, particularly the ratio of methane isotopes, provide insights into how objects like this might form. The unusual isotopic ratio suggests that this object likely formed similarly to a typical star, collapsing from a larger gas cloud rather than accumulating matter from an accretion disk around the star. Before the James Webb Space Telescope, such detailed observations were impossible. Now we can unravel the formation history of these objects based on our understanding of other celestial bodies like stars and planets. It's truly mind-blowing what we can achieve with this incredible telescope in just a short time. As we await further discoveries, we will continue to explore brown dwarfs and these intriguing binary systems in future videos. If you're interested in learning more about previous discoveries related to the brown dwarfs, check the videos in the description. Until the mystery of Jumbo 24 is resolved, that's the latest update.